Supposing, let me use an illustration to explain this. Supposing I brought a cake here, baked by some very good baker. I just brought it, I didn't even buy it, I just brought it here, and I cut it and pass it all around, and you eat it and you say, "Boy, Brother Zai, this is a fantastic cake." I'm not even proud because I didn't bake it. But if I had baked it, and then you say it's a fantastic cake, then I'll feel a little proud. When somebody says, "Brother, you're such a humble brother," do you feel proud of it? If you do, you must have manufactured your humility, like my making the cake. That's the illustration. If your humility was given by God, you cannot be proud of it, even when people praise you for it. Just like I cannot be proud of a cake which I did not bake. If somebody appreciates your holiness, you're such a godly brother, and you feel proud of it, it must be something you manufactured yourself. If it was what God did in you, you could not be proud of it, like a cake which somebody else baked. If you give a message and people appreciate it greatly, if you produce the message, you'll be proud of it. If God gave it to you, like the cake somebody else baked, you're not even tempted to pride. You think those servants in Cana were tempted to pride when they took that wine? We didn't make it, we're just distributing it. We are not in the production business, we are only in the distribution business. Praise God for that. Dear brothers and sisters, there's far more spiritual pride in us than we think. The reason being, we think that we may manufacture these things ourselves. Let's learn these two things: the depth of sin that is in religious people, and the fantastic pride that is in religious people who have not understood that everything God gives is a free gift.